sanctuary, O pure and holy, and tried and true. And with thanksgiving, oh, I'll be a living sanctuary. Thank you.
me as I pray for the church in this city from Ephesians chapter 1, verse 17. That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give to you a spirit of wisdom and of revelation in the knowledge of Him. Lord, we come before you as Paul did for the church in Ephesus. Lord, we lift before you the church in this city. Lord, we lift before you Kansas City. Lord, every believer who calls on your name. Lord, those who believe in you, Jesus, who love you. I ask you that you, Father of glory, would give to your bride in this city the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. In greater measure, you would give good gifts to your children. We ask you for the Spirit of wisdom, the Spirit of revelation, and the knowledge of Jesus. Lord, I pray by the revelation of your Son, Father, that you would magnify the worth, the glory of Jesus, that you would reveal him, that your church would be aligned with his worth, that she would gaze upon him, that her life would be aligned to his beauty, and all else she would give to wisdom, to a life of pursuing him, of knowing him, of forsaking all, of losing all, that she may gain Christ and be found in him. So Lord, I ask you, in the name of Jesus, would you give the Holy Spirit, reveal Jesus, reveal his worth.
Oh, Father of glory, give wisdom, give revelation, give the Holy Spirit to your bride.
Take the things of Jesus and make them known.
And take the things that belong to Jesus.
Said you will not leave us as orphans. Come to us. This is our greatest need in this hour, is for a revelation of your Son. Lord, I pray every church that gathers in this city, Lord, whether in a home or in a building, Lord, I pray for every believer who works about in the marketplace, Lord, those who will go to work even tomorrow morning for this next week and this next new year, Lord, I pray for their need in this hour for grace in the knowledge of God. Lord, I pray, give the Holy Spirit to your church. Lord, I ask you to enrich your church in everything, Lord. I ask you, the Spirit, that you would give to your church the wealth of the knowledge of God. Lord, the riches of Christ would be far greater than the love of this world. Oh, I ask you, make your Son the prize. Make him the joy set before your bride in this city. I ask you, make your bride rich in this city. Reveal your Son in great glory and honor. As he is worthy of love, I ask you, reveal him as the worthy one. Lord, we ask you, as those songs which surround your throne concerning you, concerning the Lamb slain, I pray that the church in this city would join in and exult in the worthiness of Jesus, that she would abandon all. To him be the glory and the dominion, all blessing and glory, all honor, all power, all riches be unto the Lamb. We ask you, give your bride the vision of your Son again. Reveal his worth and his majesty. Turn her eyes upon your Son in this city. We pray in the name of Jesus, glorify your Son.
Would you glorify Jesus?
Let them know your thoughts towards them. Give your bride a revelation of Jesus.
Come give your bride understanding of who he is.
Understanding of how he feels.
Reveal
towards
Christ
in the eyes of our understanding. Make him known. Let us know the riches of Christ. Beauty of this man named Jesus Christ.
Make him center. Light and truth. Come fill our eyes with light and truth. Come fill our eyes with light and truth. Come fill our eyes with light and truth.
Church of Kansas City, Romans chapter 15. Now may the God of patience and comfort grant you to be like-minded toward one another according to Christ Jesus, that you may with one mind and one mouth glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing. You may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Please join me as I pray. Father in heaven, we approach your throne of grace tonight. We come before you. Oh, Father, we thank you for who you are. We thank you that you know the things that we need even before we ask. We thank you that you are kind and you are gracious. You are compassionate. Thank you that you love us. We say that we belong to you. We say that we are the ones that you have adopted for your very own. We are your inheritance, Father. Father, we lift up before you all those who are called by your name, all those who have been redeemed by the blood of your Son, Jesus. We lift up before you the saints, the excellent ones, in whom is all your delight. Father of glory, we ask you tonight, according to the good pleasure of your heart, that you would release to us a measure of the Holy Spirit to every denomination, to every congregation that calls upon the name of the Lord Jesus in truth. We ask you for every believer. We ask you that you would grant us in this hour to be like-minded concerning the faith. We ask you that you would restore unto us, Lord, apostolic doctrine. You would restore unto us apostolic lifestyles and apostolic power by the Holy Spirit. I ask you, Lord, that you would give unto us unity of the faith. That you would give unto us the thing that matters most, the worth and the value of your Son, Jesus. I ask you that lesser things would fall to the wayside, that with one mind and one mouth, we would contend earnestly for the faith of the gospel, Lord, that we would glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. I ask you, Lord, for a corporate witness in Kansas City of Christ in the church. I ask you that the glory of Jesus would shine in our lives and in our message all over this city. I ask you in Jesus' name, unify your church, Lord, and let us shine in the city in Jesus' name.
Cause us to be like-minded.
Continuing to pray that the God of hope would fill you with all joy and peace in believing, to abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Father, we come before you together, Lord, and we ask you for release of grace upon us according to your love for your own people, Lord. We ask you that you would give us more of the Holy Spirit. We ask you, Lord, for the places that we are discouraged and downcast, to the places that we have given up hope. I pray, Lord, for pastors and leaders in the body of Christ all over this city, that we would abound in hope by the power of your Spirit, that you would give us fresh vision, that you would give us fresh faith. I ask you that you would give us joy and peace in believing the message of the Bible again afresh. I ask you that you would renew our hearts. I ask you, Lord, that you would put, Lord, fresh zeal and passion in our hearts, in the hearts of pastors and leaders in this city. I ask you, God, encourage us. I ask you, lift our hearts up. Give us grace and glory. I ask you in Jesus' name, fill us with joy and peace in believing in Jesus.
Fill us with joy and peace.
Let us take delight in serving you. Refresh us, renew us.
Oh, joy and peace in believing in you.
Encourage every heart.
Refresh me. May we live as those who have this living hope as the anchor for our souls.
Like to invite you to a time of rapid fire prayer. I invite you to pray for the church in your own city. If you're a visitor here, you'd like to pray for the church in your own city. Pray that the Lord would send revival to his church, send the Holy Spirit. Just 5 second prayers, 10, 15 of you just want to line up behind me. Lord, today we ask you for the church in our city, that you would indeed give joy and peace by the Holy Spirit. Lord, I pray for those who are downcast in their souls. Lord, I ask you to refresh and revive your church. Lord, I ask you, God of hope, would you revive the hopeless? Lord, that you would remind your church of the hope to which you've called her. Lord, of the inheritance that you have laid up for her, the reward that is to be revealed at your appearing. Lord, I ask you again, lift up the eyes of your church in this city. Lord, revive your church by the Spirit in Jesus' name.
Joy and peace.
I lift up before you the Church of Washington, D.C., and I ask you, Lord, that you would fill her with fresh hope, with fresh faith. You'd fill her with purity, Lord. I ask you that you would encourage the hearts of intercessors, Lord. I ask you, Lord, that you would set watchmen on the wall day and night in our nation's capital, in Jesus' name.
Father, we ask you for the church in Amarillo, Texas, God, that you would release the spirit of revival on the hearts of the ministers and those in a congregation, and that you would begin to cause them to burn with that spirit of burning that's around your throne, Jesus.
Father, we lift up the church in Ellensburg, Washington to you, and I ask just for a release of your love and unity to be all throughout Ellensburg, Lord, that you would unite the body of Christ with bridal identity of your zealous love, Jesus. Amen.
Holy Spirit, we come before you in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Holy Spirit, for revival in San Diego, God. Amongst the streets, we bind and loosen the strong man in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Father God, for mercy drops falling and your Shekinah glory coming forth in the name of Jesus. And your scepter coming out in the midst of San Diego, Father God, and releasing things right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Joy and peace in believing in you, all 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 joy and peace.
Have glory in your church. Spotless bride, perfected in love.
Celestial, clamamos por el Ecuador. Derrama de tu espíritu en el Ecuador, Señor, del norte al sur, del este al oeste, Señor. Yo te pido que tus ríos de agua viva fluyan en el Ecuador. En el nombre de Cristo Jesús, derrama de tu espíritu en el Ecuador.
I thank you, Father, that you set the church of Northwest Arkansas on the high hill. We ask, God, that you establish your prayer room. We ask that you bring the singers, musicians, the gatekeepers, the intercessors, God, those that will proclaim your name. Bless this area in Jesus' name.
God, I ask you for the church in Cairo, Egypt. Lord, I ask that you would strengthen her by the spirit of your might. I ask that in the midst of persecutions, pressures, and rumors of war, God, I ask that you would come, that you would be her joy and her peace in the midst of it. Lord, we ask and we prophesy and proclaim strength to the church in Cairo, Egypt.
I just pray for the Mormon Church of Kansas City that you would exalt your son as Yahweh and let them know not just head knowledge, but heart knowledge of your truth.
I pray for your bride, Seattle, Washington, God, that she is rising up out of her sleep and she is awakening with all glory and splendor. I thank you, Lord, that she is falling madly in love with you, God, and that she will walk out the fullness of her destiny with fearless in the days ahead, with all dominion. She will conquer all things, and Father, for you, in you, and through you.
Lord, I just pray for revival in Dallas, Texas. Lord God, we pray that you pour out your spirit, pour out your fire, God. May your fire come and dissolve all religion in Dallas, Texas, God. May you awaken the churches in Dallas, Texas, God. May you rise up prayer houses of prayer, Lord Jesus. May the fire of God burn in every church in Dallas, Texas, and may they be ignited for evangelism, God. May they go out and they win the lost, God. We pray that you send laborers into the harvest from Dallas, Texas, and they would bring in this end-time harvest in Jesus' name.
Dear God, we lift up Walworth County in Wisconsin, and I ask you to send revival, God, to each church. I ask you to ignite the pastor's hearts and the people's hearts and everyone to lift up the name of Jesus and to know you in intimacy, God, as you desire. Jesus.
Church in New Jersey. I pray for the House of Prayer at Eastern Gate. I pray, Father, that you would raise up forerunners and bring musicians and singers and intercessors. Father, give us love sickness for Jesus. Let us be abandoned to you, Father. Unite your people. Give us unity and help us to love you with all of our heart and soul and mind and strength. In Jesus' name.
Father, I also pray for the Church of New Jersey. I ask that you would open the eyes of their hearts, Lord, that they would step into their identity as your bride, God, and that your love would hit their heart and that they would begin to usher in your coming, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Jesus, I intercede for your church in Michigan, and I ask you, Father, that you would have the fullest intentions of your heart in her, God, that she would walk in healing, in wholeness, all that you died for, Lord, the unity of the Spirit, the bond of peace, Lord. Call forth the spirit of prayer, readiness for the day of the Lord, in Jesus' name.
Heavenly Father, let the city of Los Angeles, Jesus, as our encore of your glory, Father, let's go all back, praise back to you, Jesus, bring them Seymour's props to the past, God. Let's give you all honor, glory, and praise to you, Jesus.
The church in San Jose and California, Father God, I pray that they would not quench your spirit, Lord, and that they would really get serious about the things of God, Lord. And I pray for intercession of prayer, and I just pray, Father, for the spirit of repentance, Lord, that we would not put materialism in things that aren't important to mean nothing, Lord, that you would just move in your spirit, that they would not quench it anymore, Lord, that they would allow your spirit to move and the people be touched, Lord, and get delivered, Lord. We need to get delivered in California, Father God, have mercy. Lord, we put all these stupid things that don't mean anything to you first. Father God, and we ask, God, we cry out for your mercy. Mercy on California, Lord.
Yes, Lord, we pray for the Church of San Jose, California. God, we ask that you would give us a fresh hunger for you, Jesus. You would give us a fresh thirst for you, Jesus. We ask for revival in the city of San Jose, God. We ask for fresh fire to fall. Holy Spirit, that you would be poured out on the city of San Jose. We ask, God, for revival to come. In Jesus' mighty name we ask.
Father, I just pray for the Church of Buffalo, New York, and I just pray that you will send your Shekinah glory into Buffalo, New York's church. And I just pray that you will let them see the fullness of your spirit and that you will help them in good times and bad.
Father, we just thank you and praise you. We just pray for the churches in Tulsa, Oklahoma, Father, that you'll send forth true revival, Father, that your Holy Spirit will have its way, Lord, that you'll bind every spirit of religion and false revival, Lord, that once again, miracles of healing and deliverance will be in abundance flowing from this nation's Father. We just thank you and praise you that you will even raise up an apostolic prayer house in that city, Lord, that will let your light shine forth far and wide. Thank you and praise you for it. In the name of Jesus.
Jésus Christ, je te demande que tu envoies ton amour à toute l'église de le monde. Oh Lord, I just ask you to pour your spirit on Arlington, Virginia.
Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for your blessing. I pray to you right now. I want to just pray and ask you to watch the Church of Oasis in Old Placerville, Sacramento, California. I just ask, Father God, that you just open up their hearts and let them come complete obedience to you, that you would, that they will hear your word and what you have to say to them, Father God. I just ask right now that you give your hand of protection over them. Raise them up, raise up the pastor, Father God, and his wife, and your people. I thank you so much for your brothers and sisters in Christ.
Father God, I just ask you to pray for the church in Cerritos, California. You prepare them like the bride, and really let them understand your way, and let them have no divisions. Let them walk with your Holy Spirit and with power, and your fire, revival fire, will break out once more.
God, I just lift up the church in Maine. I just pray that you would make them lovesick lovers of Jesus, that you would just give them a paradigm shift, that you would establish your house of prayer in the state of Maine, that you would come to the University of Maine, and that you would bring your spirit there, and that you would send down your angels and bind up the darkness and the powers of hell in the name of Jesus.
Lord, I just pray, God, that you would send revival to the city of New Orleans, Lord. You said that you would send a fire and it would devour. You would send a fire and it would burn. So Lord, I ask you to send those revival fires to our city, Lord, that many might be saved, healed, and delivered, not for the glory of any man, Lord, but for the glory of Jesus.
Father God, I thank you that you just sent revival fires to Robinson, Illinois, and all the churches in Crawford County, and all the small counties and all the small churches in Southern Illinois. Father, I thank you that you don't care about the size of the town or the size of anything, but you can do big things in little places. So we just pray, Holy Spirit, fall in your power. Holy Spirit, fall and bring your church together. Father, may it not be about lifting up any one church, but Father, may it be about lifting up your church, that your name would receive the glory and the honor and the praise in Jesus' name.
Father God, in Jesus' name, I pray for the city of Providence, Rhode Island, Lord, the city called by your name. Lord, I ask that you would rescue and recover that city for your glory, Lord, that you would bring light to those that are sitting in darkness and in the shadow of death there, Lord, that you guide its feet into the way of peace, Lord. I pray for a manifestation of your presence, Lord, of your revival, Lord God, that you would restore that which is under the ground, Lord, the seeds of revival, Lord, that you would bring back the city called by your name, Lord, that you would display your goodness, your character, Lord, your faithfulness, Jesus, that your name would be proclaimed in the streets of that city, in Jesus' name.
Father, I just bring before you Conway, Arkansas, and the surrounding Central Arkansas region, and I ask, Father, that you would cause your bride to come together and unify, and I ask, God, that you would let us align what is what on your heart for the Conway, Arkansas, and the surrounding areas, God. And I just ask that you would draw all men into your Son in the Central Arkansas region. Amen.
Father God, I just thank you for all the hearts and souls in this place right now. And thank you, Lord, for the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony for all churches coming together, unity worldwide. In Jesus' name, amen.
Daddy God, I lift up all the churches in Georgia, Lord. I ask that you give them a bitterness in their mouth for sin, Lord. That you just bring this bitterness to their mouth where they cannot stand sin. Father, call them to righteousness, holiness, purity. Jesus, you're so good. Love you. In your name.
Father, I lift up Central Florida to you, Lord God, specifically Lyman High School, God. I pray that you would just send your spirit to that high school, Lord, that they would encounter your love, Lord God, that every last student would know you, Jesus, God, and that you would raise up laborers in there, and God, that they would preach your word, Lord God, just you would send supernatural signs and wonders to bear witness of what's spoken, Father God. I just pray for this year, Lord God, to be the year in Jesus' name.
Story. Taking my
You're always with me. Oh, you're good.
continuing to pray for the church. Continuing to pray for the church of Kansas City from Philippians 1, 9 through 11. That the bride of Kansas City and that our love may abound still more and more in the knowledge of God and all discernment, that we might approve and rejoice in the things that are excellent, that we might be sincere and without offense till the day of Christ, being filled with the fruits of righteousness. And I'm thinking of love abounding like our heart would overflow with a good theme, that our heart would overflow, that our love would abound like we saw with Jesus and his disciples and with the church and the church of Acts, that our heart would overflow with the theme of the Father that we saw with his Son, Jesus Christ. It says in Psalms 145:8, the Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger, and great in mercy. We see that theme all through the Bible. And in Joel 2, verse 13, so rend your heart and not your garments. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and great in kindness, for he relents in doing harm. And we see the theme of mercy all through Matthew 5. I mean, we forgive each other. We go the extra mile. We choose to be peacemakers because we want to reflect the image of the Father, which is a God whose mercy endures forever. So, Father, we come before you tonight, lifting up before you the church of Kansas City and this house, God, and we're asking that our love would abound still more and more in the knowledge of God and all discernment, my God. Lord, we want our love to abound like we saw when you sent your Son. You so loved the world that you sent your Son in your mercy. And Jesus, as you walked this earth and you reflected the image of the Father and you were about your Father's business, you constantly walked in mercy and compassion and love for others, God. We want our love to abound in such a way that we reflect your image as a forerunner, as a burning and shining lamp, that we would shine with those fruits of righteousness, that we would rejoice in those things that are excellent, like we saw in your Son, Jesus Christ, and with your disciples, God. So, Lord, we're asking that you would cause our hearts to overflow with a theme that reflects the Father. Lord, that we don't have to convince people of your love, that they would see it in how we treat each other, God. Lord, that we would love our neighbor because our heart overflows in such a way that we don't criticize our neighbor, Father, but that we would have mercy on those around us, Father, that we would win them with your loving kindness because our heart abounds. Lord, cause our love to abound, and cause our heart to overflow with a theme that we see all through the Bible, the God of mercy, the God who is slow to anger and compassion, the God who forgives us 77 times 7 because he's merciful, my God. Oh, Lord, we want to walk out in Matthew 5. We want to be that peacemaker. We want to walk in that meekness, my God. We want to be poor in spirit, God. Humble us. Come, my God. Lord, humble us in such a way. Lord, cause your love to abound in such a way that they would see Jesus. Cause our love to abound in Jesus' name.
Let your love abound. Let it overflow in our hearts.
Let your love abound. Let our hearts be found abiding in you.
They may know that we are Christians by our love.
By our love.
Still more and more in the knowledge of God.
Cause our hearts to overflow in love.
Let your love abound. So more and more we pray.
The fragrance of Christ will go forth through us.
They will know that we are Christians by our love. By our love that we will know that we are Christians by our love. By our
Christ-like.
Love. They would know.
Bearers.
We are Christians by our love, by our love.
are Christians by our love, that they would know that we are Christians by our love, that they would know that we are Christians by our love, that they would know that we are Christians by our love, that they would know.
That's the shine we saw on your thumb. Excellent, being without offense till the day of Christ, being filled with the fruits of righteousness. My God, come, come as an all-consuming fire and burn away those things that would be hindering us from rejoicing in the things that are excellent, the excellent way we see in Matthew 5, God. We would be filled with the fruits of righteousness. Oh, you being the vine, Jesus, and Father, the vine dresser, come and prune us. We want to bear the fruits of righteousness. We invite the conviction of the Holy Spirit, God. Come, convict our hearts that we might turn and repent from those things that are hindering us from rejoicing in the things that are excellent. We make room for you tonight in the Bride of Kansas City, and we say we want to be filled with the fruits of righteousness. We want to rejoice in what you rejoice in, God. Come, humble us, God. Humble us. We will turn. We will turn from those offenses. We will turn from murmuring. We will turn from complaining. We will turn from jealousy, envy, and strife, God. Lord, we want to be filled with the fruits of righteousness, Lord. In Jesus' name, cause us to rejoice in the things that are excellent.
Cause us to rejoice in excellent things.
Fill us with the fruits of righteousness. Fill us with love, all joy, peace, and believing.
Burn away those things that are trying to quench your love.
Burn away everything hindering your love. Little foxes and all the compromises.
That we would be sincere without offense.
Come and catch the
with might through his spirit in the inner man. that he will dwell in us, and we will understand how wide, how high, how deep is his love for us. Father God, I stand today and we pray for the Hispanic church here in Kansas City, in the United States, Lord, and all around the world, in Latin America, Lord. Lord, we pray that you will surround us with your love, that we will understand how much you love us, Lord Jesus, that we will understand that we will be rooted and grounded in your love, that we will understand that we love you because you first loved us. Lord, we pray that the church, the Hispanic church all around the world, Lord, will be rooted and grounded in your love, that we will understand how much you love us, Lord. We need you. We need you to love you. We need to understand your love. Open up our minds, Lord Jesus. Open our eyes. We need to see your face. We need to see your face that look at us in love. We need to feel your love. Lord Jesus, we pray today that the Hispanic church all around the world will be rooted and grounded in your love.
Root us and ground us
in the very love of Christ. Establish every heart and every heart understand. The width, the length. Surround every heart with your love.
Alrededor del mundo entienda cuán ancho, grande, profundo es tu amor por nosotros. Padre, sacude todo lo que tiene que ser sacudido. Arranca de lo más profundo de nuestro ser todo lo que esconde tu inmenso amor por nosotros. Arráiganos y cimentanos en tu amor. Llénanos de tu amor, Señor. Atráenos a ti con lazos de amor. Te necesitamos. Necesitamos conocer de tu amor. Root us and ground us in your love, Lord Jesus. Draw us to you. Bind us in your love.
Bind us together in your love.
We need your love, God. Bind us together in your love.
Would you show them the width, the length, the depth, the height?
Oh, the very love of Christ.
They would comprehend and they would understand this love.
Take them deep in understanding. Let them understand this love. Let them know the love that drove you to the cross.
Root and ground them in this love. Root and ground them
within the Hispanic church in Kansas City, in the United States, and all around the world. Lord, I pray today that your presence will be so thick that we will feel you, that we will be able to feel your embrace. Lord, let your presence, let your glory be showing all around Latin America. Lord, let your bride feel you. Let your bride feel your presence. Señor, te pedimos que tu presencia llene la iglesia en Latinoamérica, en la ciudad de Kansas, en los Estados Unidos, que tu iglesia hispana pueda sentir tu presencia. Que apreciemos, Señor, esa presencia, la gloria de ti, Señor. Necesitamos de tu gloria. Derrama de tu gloria en la iglesia latina. Pour out your spirit, Lord, in the Hispanic church in Latin America.
Bother me, for I know he is.
Jesus. Oh, to be loved by Him. Oh, to have joy and peace within. Oh, to be loved by Him. Oh, to be loved by Jesus. Oh, to be loved by Him. Oh, to have joy and peace within. Oh, to be loved by Him.